George Wallace, me, I'm in New York City, and I'm looking for Megyn Kelly because you said Santa Claus is white. Santa, you think he's white in Jamaica? I don't think so. You want to know the truth? I be thinking, Santa Claus is Chinese. Read the bottom of the toys.
Tonight on Access TV, it's Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Ophira Eisenberg, Mick Diflo, Chris Cotton, Gary Valentine. This week's host, George Wallace. Gotham Comedy Live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, George Wallace!
Gotham Comedy Live! Come on, come on, make some more noise. Let's have some fun in here. Well, let it roll, let it roll.
George Wallace.
George. George.
Come on and make me jump. George Wallace.
When them old big head boys.
Come on and make me jump. George.
Just a little magic to start the show, a little magic. Most of you, you didn't even know I did magic, did you? Didn't you see me stop that music? That was magic. I stopped it, and I can.
Twas.
The first thing I want you to know is I'm not crazy.
Hey, for real though.
Turn it up so I can hear.
Come on and make me
jump. Should. Oh, got a man checking me out, too. Got a man. Let's give the man a little bit. Come on, hit it again.
George Wallace.
Oh, he's into it. Yeah, come on.
Make me jump.
That's good. Come on, that's good. I'm so happy to be in New York. Let me tell you something. I don't know where y'all from, but you're in the greatest city in the world, New York City. New York City, the greatest city in the world. And I'm going to say the same thing tomorrow night when I get to L.A. So, but when you think about it, when you come to New York, if you can't laugh in this city, you can't laugh anywhere, can you?
That's right.
I just get off the airplane, people start saying stupid shit. I'm walking to an airport, man. Hey, Mr. Wallace, you in town? Stupid stuff. I called Delta Airlines and said, I need a flight to Atlanta around noon. The lady says, is that 12 noon?
Oh.
I said, no, that's 2 noon, you stupid heifer. People can say some stupid stuff. So I'm walking here, right? And I'm passing this hamburger shop. What do they call the Five Guys? Five Guys? That's just too many people touching my meat. That's at least 9 hands touching my meat. And then I'm walking down, 2 blocks away, they just opened up a brand new Ethiopian restaurant. A brand new Ethiopian restaurant. Now, personally, y'all, I didn't even know they had food in Ethiopia, okay? Okay, that's a little political incorrect, isn't it? I don't give a shit, people being PC. I'm gonna be PI for the rest of the week. I'm gonna be PI. You can't talk about fat people. Why can't I talk about fat people? I'm fat. In fact, somebody told me to get a trainer. A trainer is $150 an hour. Isn't that a lot of money?
Yes.
If I pay somebody $150 an hour for a trainer, I ain't picking up shit. I'm telling you that right now. Go ahead and show me what you want me to do. Come on, give me 12 reps. You can do it. Pick it up. Yeah, I'm fat. And Dr. Oz said, a man my size overweight, every 35 pounds you lose, you can gain an inch. On your tallywhack. You laugh if you want to. This time next week, I will have lost 105 pounds, all right? So when you get to New York, you get here, and you start laughing, and you got Donald Trump is an idiot. Pretty soon, his lips are going to meet his hair. This guy's adamant about building the wall, right? He wants to build this wall, and the Mexicans are building tunnels. The Mexicans are building tunnels. Donald Trump wants to build a wall. He's so stupid, he doesn't even know. I wrote this joke 20 years ago. Who's gonna build a wall? You think the Mexicans are stupid? You think they're gonna build on a wall and not leave a hole in it? Hell, they ain't crazy. You let the Mexican build that wall look like a checkerboard with the holes in it. And let me tell you, he's running for office. And another thing about Mexicans, talking about these Mexicans. If I'm ever president of these United States, I'm putting Mexicans, any Mexicans in here? Now, you raise your hand. Don't be scared. I'm not with immigration. Come on. You're going to be all right. If I'm ever in charge of this country, every cabinet post, every administrative position, I'm putting Mexicans in charge of everything. Go ahead and ask me why. Because Mexicans can get shit done. Give me credit. Anything can be done, a Mexican can do it. Walk into a Chinese restaurant, eat your Chinese food. When you're walking out, stop. Peep in the kitchen. See who's making your moo-goo guy pan. Go on back there and say hello to Maylene Sanchez. Mexicans are the smartest people in the world. Anything can be done. The Mexicans came over here, we were eating churches and Popeyes. What did the Mexicans say? We can do better. They gave us El Pollo Loco. El Pollo, have you ever had that chicken? That chicken is so good, another chicken will eat that chicken. That's how good that chicken is. Mexican, I can tell you things about Mexicans. Mexicans don't even know. Who's the richest man in the world? Mexican. People don't know that. Carlos Slim. Y'all learning from me. It fluctuates between he and Bill Gates. I can tell you things about Mexican. You ever notice you never see a homeless Mexican? You never, ever see a homeless Mexican. I be thinking about stuff like that. You never see a homeless Mexican. Think about it. You give a Mexican like 8 bricks. You give a Mexican 8 bricks and 3 packs of chewing gum. You come back a week later, they got townhouses and condos all up the whole block. And a brand new Home Depot up on the corner. A brand new home. I drove by Home Depot. I drove by Home Depot the other day. I swear I saw El Chapo sitting out in the front. Before I go any further, anybody here work at Home Depot? Does anybody here work at Home Depot? Does anybody here work at Home Depot? Damn, I feel like I'm actually in the store. And talking about running for the White House, and just think if Donald Trump does make it, first thing he's gonna do is paint it gold and probably add another 30 stories, but I think I should be president of these United States. I wanna be fair. People that wanna drink and drive, I think we should have a lane for these people. We're gonna have one lane, both directions. You make it home, you know what you're doing. And another thing, we need better security at the White House, don't you think so? People are jumping this fence, white people jumping the fence. Every black person in America went, ain't no way in hell a black man could have made it over that fence. Because those dogs be going, I wish that Negro would touch that fence. I'll tear his ass up. No, you ain't never seen, they teach those dogs to eat black people. Y'all don't know this. They teach those dogs to eat black people. I'm not making this up. They had to retrain those dogs not to eat President Obama. I'm serious. They had to retrain those dogs. Every time President Obama gets off that helicopter, what is he doing? His ass is running, those dogs are after him. That's what I'm trying to tell you. You never seen those two little kids out in the yard playing, have you? Because they teach those dogs to eat black people. I'm talking about black people, a lot of white people in here tonight too. Let me talk to these white people while I'm here. White people, stop looking for ghosts. Stop looking for ghosts. There's 13 TV shows on right now all about ghosts. You ever seen them just... Dude, did you hear that? Did you see that? Dude, I'm getting a little queasy right now. Something's going over my body. Did you hear that? No, we didn't see shit. You didn't see shit. We didn't hear shit. You didn't hear shit. We got cameras. Nobody saw nothing. White people, stop looking for ghosts. And ghosts are stupid. And you tell them I said so when you see them. All these multi-million-dollar mansions in the neighborhood, ghosts got to live across the street in a boarded-up house with no heat, no lights. You never see black people talking about ghosts, do you? Ghosts don't like us. You'll never see black people talking about ghosts, do you? We don't like them. They don't like us. Ghosts come into black people's house. Boo. Yeah, boo. Sit your ass down over here and shut the hell up. Ghosts don't like us. We don't like them. There's a haunted house in Atlanta, Georgia, across the street from me. 6 months ago, a black family moved in next to the haunted house. I went home last week. The ghosts had a U-Haul backed up to their house. Furniture was floating into the truck. This is so good up here. I'm just having so much fun. This is the best club, and this place is beautiful, is it not? I got so many jokes to do. I'm gonna wrap it up. I got so many jokes to do, and I got jokes. Some of these jokes might be funny, might not. I don't give a damn. I'm doing these jokes. I'm gonna talk about Bloomingdale's when I come back up here, all right? Yeah, Bloomingdale's, the most beautiful people in the world. I talk about it right now. The most beautiful people in the world work at Bloomingdale's. If you ever come to New York, go to Bloomingdale's, okay? The women there are so beautiful. I'm not going to lie to you. The women are so beautiful at Bloomingdale's. And I'm going to tell you the truth, too. Some of the men look better than the women. So when you go into Bloomingdale's, if you're not sure of your sexuality, when you come out, you might come out. Let's get the show rolling. Let's get the show rolling. Let's have some fun. Come on, let's get it rolling.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Ophira Eisenberg is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
My, is this the hottest show in the city or what? We are having too much fun up in here. Let's keep this show rolling. This next lady coming up here, it's like she's like a company. It's like more than one. You're getting two for the price of one. Please enjoy Ophira Eisenberg. Come on. Ophira Eisenberg. Come on. From the Nightly Show. Come on. Come on, Larry Wilmore. I know you.
I know, this is very nice. You are getting a great deal, two for one. Yeah, I know. You've been getting me and all the carbs I've been eating. No, clearly I'm pregnant. I am clearly pregnant. And I'm old. I'm old to be doing this for the first time. So, or as I've been told, I'm both high risk and an inspiration. I'm feeling great. Don't worry about it. There's only one problem, which is that I don't really like kids. So, see how this goes. They say you'll like your own. Fingers crossed. I don't know this asshole yet. I have no idea. They could suck. I don't know. We'll find out. Everyone was surprised. I was surprised. My friends were surprised. So they were like, oh my God, how did it happen? Really? How did it happen? Oh, I was walking down the street and a vat of sperm fell on me. Must have been that toilet seat at Penn Station. I know, that's possible. I know. It is very possible. No, the story is very cliche. It was Valentine's Day. My husband took me for a very nice, very expensive dinner, and I felt guilty. So I'm pretty sure that's how most Jewish babies were conceived. But people can be really weird. Someone just came out to me. I didn't even know him. They just went, in vitro? I was like, oh, no, in dico. old-fashioned method we've used. But I'm glad I didn't do this in my 20s. I would have thought I was ruining my life. But now I'm ruining someone else's life, so it's totally cool. And I'm very busy, so I don't really think of this as a baby. I think of it as an intern. I'm going to have an intern. Hopefully they can do social media, get them tweeting right away, you know, all the stuff I don't want to do. And I live in Brooklyn. So, nice. Yeah, it's the neighborhood is almost too hip for me. I went into this. You can't get a normal cup of coffee. I went to this place. I'm ordering a coffee. I go, hey, can I grab a coffee? Guy goes, what do you want? I go, I don't know. You don't have any menus. He goes, no menus. It's a conversation. It's like, excuse me? He's like, yeah, we talk about it. It's like, all right. He goes, so tell me, like, what are you looking to get out of your coffee? What are you looking to get out of your coffee? I was like, all right, what am I looking to get in my coffee? Well, I'm looking to get a bit of a boost and to take a shit. Like, why are you doing this to me? Why are you doing this to me? I just want a coffee. And that is the only place around there where someone's actually touched me. You know, they tell you that people are going to touch you. It's only happened once. But this guy, actually, he didn't touch me. He beelined up to my stomach with his head and then kissed it 3 times and then looked at me and said, it's a boy. And I was so shocked, and I just was like, oh my God, I'm not pregnant. And the color just left his face. He was so freaked out. He went from like sadness to then disgust at what he was potentially kissing otherwise. And I was like, oh, I should save this guy, right, from the misery I just put him through. And then I was like, or I could just walk away. And I just walked away. Yeah, it was kind of amazing. It was kind of amazing. I don't know what it is that drives everyone crazy. Like, what is it? What sex is it? I don't know. I don't want to know. Everyone's like, you need to know. So I'm like, fine. It's transgender. Gonna give it a nice gender neutral name like equality or open or Black Lives Matter. You know, something good. I have a weird name. I'm not gonna repeat that mistake. My name is Ophira. It's not a made up name, that is a real name. It's just a very old, archaic Hebrew name that didn't catch on. So, not gonna repeat that mistake. I miss alcohol, oh my God. I do miss alcohol. No, it's good, enjoy it, yeah. And I like drinking. I'm the kind of person that goes out for dinner with a friend and I'm like, let's get two bottles of wine so you have something to drink, you know? And so when I wasn't drinking, I thought, oh, my friends are gonna know for sure. And we're out at a bar. And my friend's like, what do you want? Do you want a vodka soda? Do you want a, you know, whiskey ginger? What do you want? And I was like, I'll just have a seltzer. I was like, here we go. They're all gonna be like, oh my God. My friend goes, good for you. I'm like, what? They're like, I think, you know, we wanted to say something to you, but I like the fact that you got to it on your own. I'm like, you assholes, I'm not an alcoholic, I'm pregnant. They're like, whoa, no one thinks you should be a mother, all right? Like, that is some funny stuff, but yeah, why don't you just work on the not drinking? We'll see how that goes, sweetheart. In Brooklyn, too, there's yoga studios everywhere. I took a prenatal yoga class. I'm not very touchy-feely. And you know how, like, one ladybug is adorable? But 30 ladybugs all together is sort of like a creepy infestation trying to kill you. Yeah, one pregnant person, whatever. 30 in a room is one of the most disgusting things I have ever been part of. It felt like we were part of, like, chosen as a reproductive experiment by the government. You know, like part of some sort of breeding initiative to repopulate Israel. And then at the beginning, you have to go around and you have to, you know, it's all touchy-feely. So they're like, just tell us your name, where you're at in your pregnancy, and what you're craving. And I'm looking for that one person that's also like, this is total bullshit, right? But I can't find them. I'm like, oh my God, here we go. And everyone's taking it serious. The first girl's like, hi, I'm Marcy, 24 weeks pregnant. And I guess I'm craving dark chocolate, but then again, I always am. Next girl's like, hi, I'm Sandy. I'm 12 weeks pregnant. I'm totally gonna keep this one. And craving, well, you know, I had a slice of pepperoni pizza last night, and I'm a lactose intolerant, gluten-free vegan, so I don't even know myself anymore. It's crying. I'm like, all right, someone has to lighten this up. So it comes to me, and I'm like, hey, I'm Ophira, I'm 30 weeks pregnant. What am I craving? Okay, do you guys know that thing where you're like, you're doing lines of Coke all night, and then you wake up the next day, you're like, I need a beer. And they're like, yeah, here's a pamphlet for a meeting. And I was like, glad you laughed. No one in Brooklyn prenatal yoga laughed. Thank you. All right, thank you guys so much. It was so much fun.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Mick Diflo is taking the stage when we return. We'll be right back.
can't believe Ophira was up here talking about lactose intolerance. I don't know what that is. That's a new disease you young kids have, lactose. What is it? They say you drink some milk and you're walking down the street, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, a flame of fire will shoot out of your ass. So what the hell is that? That's lactose. Well, I can't tolerate this stuff. I mean, you young kids got these new diseases. You got another one called ADD. ADD. Baby boomers, tell these young kids, when we grew up, ADD ain't nothing a good ass whooping couldn't cure, right? Huh? Your mama would slap you upside the head, tell you to get your ass over there and sit down and don't you move. And ADD was cured right there on the spot. Didn't nobody call no doctor, no prescription. Sit your punk ass down. I said, can I watch television? She said, you can watch it, but you better not turn it on. Now, let's keep this show moving right here. This guy was in the movie, TV show, everything. He's even done Inside Amy Schuller. That's pretty cool, being inside Amy. That's cool. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Mick Diflo. Come on, Mick Diflo. Make some more noise. You can do it.
I don't have much time. All right, so like you said, my nickname is Mickey. It's been Mickey since I was a little kid, you know. But I moved up to New York. I see, like, people from other countries, they have, like, these rich traditions with their names that go back hundreds of years, you know. I met a guy last week. He says, hello, my name is Ami. In Hebrew, it means great leader of people. I said, I'm Mickey. I was a date rape drug back in the 30s. Not quite so proud, really, but come from a pretty close family. My mother died a couple years ago, so I moved in with my dad because he wasn't doing so well, and he died a couple weeks later, and my family wasn't crazy about the message I left on the answering machine. Hi, this is Mick. I'm not here right now, and everyone else is dead. You can leave a message at the beep, but what's the point, really? I mean, they're gone now. Had a pretty bad drug problem growing up. I've been clean for a long time, but I'm still amazed at the crazy shit people do when they get too high. Anybody reading about the guy in the Wu-Tang Clan a couple months ago? He was high on PCP, cut his penis off. Blamed it on PCP, cut his dick off, and... I'm thinking, I don't know, I've smoked PCP before. I never once looked down and went, man, you are nothing but trouble. You have got to go. Didn't work that way for me, really. But, had a lot of jobs in the past. You know, I was actually fired from the suicide hotline for saying stuff like, you know, I'm supposed to talk you out of this, but you're making some good points here. I may jump myself after this call, sir. Listen, I gotta go. I'm starting to see why people think you're boring. Hello? Yeah. I was reading where a woman who used to work with serial killer Ted Bundy at the suicide hotline was writing a book called The Stranger Beside Me. I repeat, Ted Bundy used to work at the suicide hotline. And I'm thinking, how'd those calls go? Please don't do it. I'll get to you eventually. I'm a little backed up right now, but you're on my list, please. But, I'm starting to think about death a little now, getting older. You ever see how somebody died in the paper and you think to yourself, wow, I hope that word is not on my obituary. It'll say, like, decapitated or something like that. So I've come up with a list of words that I hope are not on my obituary. Dental records. Unrecognizable. Ripley's Believe It or Not. Traces of semen. Ooh. That's never good, folks. That's never good. Why? Anyone here not have an autistic child? Huh? I didn't think so. Well, they're coming out of the woodwork, aren't they? I'm about sick of those little fuckers. Yeah. But I'm kidding. You know, I love kids, you know, but I tell you what, I don't want to babysit your kid. I mean, I believe me, I'm not asked that much. But we have a couple, you know, downstairs from us. She's an actress. He's a Wall Street guy. And they got a little kid, Billy. He's crazy, 5 years old. They're all pretty crazy, man. And she comes up the other day. She comes up the other day, and I'll do anything to get out of watching this kid. You know, she knocks on the door, and I answer the door, and Billy's standing there ready to tear the place up. And she goes, "Can you watch Billy, please, just for an hour? Please, just for an hour. I have an audition. I can't find anybody." And I'm standing there. I got sweatpants on. I got a bowl of cereal in my hand. The TV's on in the background. I'm clearly doing nothing. And I go, "Look, I'm a pedophile." I'm not even allowed this close to the school, really. She goes, "Ah, bullshit, I had to watch the kid. I hate that fucking kid." But I hate when people use children for an example for stuff. You ever hear someone say, "Hey, you want to get grateful? Go down to the children's hospital. Look at what those poor kids are going through. You'll quit your bitching then, pal. You'll get grateful then." And I'm like, "Can you do that? Can you just go down to the front desk at children's hospital?" Yeah, I'd like to see the children, please. "Are you a friend or a relative?" "No, I've just been having a bad day." "I don't have to go in. You could just wheel one out if you want." I think so. Children's hospital. But, yeah, anybody ever hear this restaurant, Hot and Crusty? Hot and Crusty, if you're going to sink a lot of money into a restaurant, would you name it Hot and Crusty? I found out what some of the rejected names were before they came up with Hot and Crusty. Warm and Gamey. Lukewarm and Bitter. Traces of Semen. Applebee's. So I'm married now like 11 years. I have a great wife. But we, you know, I think if you're in a relationship, eventually you're probably going to ask the question. You know, you're sitting around some night talking about sex. How many people have you been with? How many people have you had sex with? And you're not going to want to hear what my wife told me. She goes, "Oh, God. I have no idea." I said, "You don't think you maybe ballpark it for me?" She goes, "That sounds right, about a ballpark." Opening day. All right, I get it. But I'll end with this. They say, you know, we don't agree on everything, even in the bedroom. For example, my wife thinks it's never appropriate during sexual role play to include a special needs character. I'm like, "Just wear the helmet, will you? You're sexy in the helmet, come on." All right, that's it from me, folks, thanks.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Chris Cotton is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs right now.
This joint is jumping. Are you having fun or what? This is too nice. I've never been to a club this nice in anywhere in America. This is a beautiful place, and you got these comedians. That last guy was a little freaky, wasn't he? But he was funny, was he not? And we're going to keep the funny rolling right now, right here in New York City. My son is here tonight. That's what his mama told me a few minutes ago. Chris Cotton is right here. He's the co-host of Audie Lane Podcast. Chris Cotton, my new son, my new baby boy.
Hey, what up, man? Some of y'all just staring at me like, yo, he fat and black. He gonna be hilarious, yeah. He look like he don't got no other life skills. This should be good. This should be real good. I'm getting fat as hell, man. I try to throw y'all off with the card again. I don't think it's working. I don't think anybody's fooled. I know I'm getting fat, because I was hanging out. I was outside just chilling, and some dude, he was standing next to me giving directions on his phone, and he used me as a landmark. That's how I know I'm getting fat. I was standing in front of a Dunkin' Donuts. I was like, you piece of shit. You think I'm bigger than a Dunkin' Donuts? How the hell? And he was getting real descriptive, too. He didn't care nothing about my feelings. And I'm just standing there like a jackass. Like, I don't want this guy to get lost. He needs me. If I leave, he's lost. He needs me. I can't go anywhere. And he just described me. He's not pulling no punches yet. Like, I'm in front of this fat, big glass of Kool-Aid looking motherfucker. Yeah. Yeah, he got on some flat tops like he's a skateboarder. No, he ain't skateboarding. He's a fat motherfucker. I'm like, Jesus Christ, I can hear you. What the hell? Care about me, man. He was giving out great directions, though. I know they was great, because I looked above my head, and one of those Google plans was just floating right above my head. I was like, motherfucker, I'm on Google Maps. This is good. Oh, man. I'm from Philly, man. I'm Philly born and raised. I'm South Philly. Born and raised. I don't know none of y'all. Y'all not from Philly. I don't know none of y'all. No. One thing I realized about growing up in Philly is I never really seen nature face-to-face my whole life. I remember the first day of summer last year, a butterfly was flying right at me. I didn't know what it was. I ran to a parked car. I never seen a butterfly that close before. I thought it was a wombat. I don't even know what the fuck a wombat is. I just screamed wombat, ran to the car. Like, wombat, poof, I hit my hip. I was like, geez, these wombats are everywhere this year. I gotta text my friends. Oh, man, I'm terrified of nature. I'm terrified of it. I don't like anything, you know what I mean? Like, true story, I was on my way to a show. I got stopped at a red light, and across the intersection was a group of 16 deer. It was a group of 16 deer. Okay, it probably was only one deer, but I was so scared. And at that moment, I understood how white women feel when y'all stop your car in a bad neighborhood. I get it now. Because I didn't think the deer were gonna do anything to me. But I still lock my door just in case, you know what I mean? Can't be too certain, that's all I'm saying. Is it just me, when you hear that automatic lock button, when you hear that lock button, it feel like a little hug come around your body, like, they can't get in here. You safe, ain't no, can't nothing get in here. I got you. Okay, I went home to my old neighborhood in Philly, I was hanging out, I was like, hey, brother man, how you doing, man? My brother. I was like, you my brother, but you look shady as hell. Cuckoo. Oh, thank you. Oh, God. If I see anything that makes me uncomfortable, I just hit that button, man. I'm like, oh, that baby is ugly. Cuckoo. Oh, God. Those nightmares can't get in here. You can't get in these. The door is locked. How you doing, officer? Cuckoo, cuckoo, cuckoo. Oh, God. I can't resist inside the car. You can't get in here. Oh, man. I grew up in a horrible neighborhood. I knew my neighborhood was horrible for a fact because I had the only dad for a 5-block radius. That's how I knew. It was to the point where I had to act like I didn't have a dad just to make friends. Other kids would come outside all angry, like, word on the street is, you got a dad? I'd be like, what? I'm like, come on, man, you know it's a dad-free neighborhood. Ain't no dads allowed around here. Like, I didn't want to be that only kid outside at recess playing with the other kids, just judging them with like a wine glass full of milk, just judging them. And then, what do you mean you don't have a dad? They're delicious this year. It was bad, man. I was terrified, man. Like, I was scared that one day some thugs were going to see me hanging out with my dad, and they was going to take them. Like I said, I'm from a bad neighborhood. They steal everything else. It's not beneath them to steal a dad. I was scared. I was going to be walking down the street. All of a sudden, I hear, yo, what's up, big man? He's going to come around here just flashing your dad.
Like he can't get snatched.
And all of a sudden I hear, cuckoo, the five dudes come out of nowhere, walk up snapping, West Side Story style, just snatch my dad, start pulling him into the shadows. I'm like, what are you doing with my dad? So, we gonna make him play catch with us, that's what we gonna do. Make him do dad shit till he gets sleepy. I feel like I lost some of y'all with that dad joke. Y'all was like, he funny, but come on, man. Black dads don't stay. He bullshit now. Oh, don't feel bad. White dads don't stay either. Oh, look, I got real quiet when I said that. You see that? Like, how you know about the white dads? Yeah. I know about the white dads. I got white friends. I eat hummus. I know what's going on. You can't bullshit me. Oh, man. Fuck, man. You know what I realized, man? This generation, we're the shittiest generation of men ever. We are. This generation of men. Do you know what a thermos is? You ever see a thermos before? Look at him. He just made a face. What? Thermos? Who? What? What? Thermos? What the fuck is a thermos? A thermos. Like, you really don't know what a thermos is. That's the saddest shit. That's how you know we're not men. I'm a piece of shit, too. We're both not men. Like, that's the mark of a man. Taking a thermos to work is man shit. Like, that's how you know you're a man. Like, I'm being real. Like, dude, I'm not a man. Like, I haven't paid my Netflix bill in 9 months. I'm going to be honest with you. I didn't know Netflix had a collection division, but they do, and they are aggressive, just so you know. It's $8 a month, but they want their money. They don't give a fuck what you do to get it. I got lucky. I was on the phone, and the guy happened to know who I am. So he was like, hey, yo, Chris, I know you're a little strapped for cash right now. So if you just let me play catch with your dad. I was like, is this Tony? From South Philly, you piece of shit. Oh, man, I'm not a man. Like my dad, he's a man. He knows how to read a map. If somebody handed me a map, I would just wipe my face with it. I don't know what the fuck to do with a map. True story, my grandpa couldn't read or write, but before he died, he owned a house. I don't know if y'all understand everything I told y'all. My grandpa couldn't read or write. He owned a house. Hey, you can clap if you want. I don't know the fuck. I can read and write, and I can't pay my Netflix bill, so I don't know what the fuck I'm doing wrong. All right, y'all, that's my time. My name is Chris Cotton. Enjoy the rest of your night.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Gary Valentine is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, is this fun or what? Is this fun or what? And I don't know, some of y'all came from out of town. Where you come from? Who's from where? Chicago, you happy to be here, aren't you? Anybody from Chicago happy as hell to be out of Chicago, trust me. They tell me the crime is so bad in Chicago, they're trying to change the emergency number to 9, but that's a whole different story. Let's keep this show rolling. We got funny coming from the King of Queens show. You've seen this guy, he's very funny. Gary Valentine right here at Gotham Comedy Live. It's Gotham Comedy Live. Here he comes, Gary. Get some butt.
I know I'm very sexy in person. And I'm in between haircuts. Well, I guess we all are, but, unless you're having a haircut right now. I just got married, so thank you, ladies, and a couple guys for trying. It was a good run. I got married 4 years ago for the first time to a Filipino family. And they're everywhere. Although I'm becoming a better swimmer because I'm eating so many fish heads. It's unbelievable. I used to eat pizza. And I come home and it's like a... Again, huh? Yeah, yeah, she's great. She's from the Philippines, you know? She's from Manila, where they make the envelopes. And, yeah, we never have to go to the post office. We have stacks, you know? Works out. I hate chores. Yeah, so anyway, I've been torn around, you know? I'm doing a little stand-up here and there. I bought a backpack, you know, and a knapsack. You know, a sack on your back. You know what I'm talking about, right? All the kids are wearing them. I like the knapsack, backpack, sack on your back, but I just get a little neurotic, you know, like if I'm ordering coffee, someone's unzipping me back there, you know. Yeah, can I get a regular... Ma'am, I felt the tug, lower left. I wish you could wear it in the front, like a baby Bjorn. Wouldn't that be good? You know, a little cumbersome, though. I know, I get it. I just wish the backpack was in the front and smaller. You could wear it down on your belt on the side. Like, I wish the backpack was a small pouch on your side, on your belt, on the side. You could wear it in the front, on your side, one zip. You keep your chapstick, your cash, and your inhaler right in there. Maybe a little baby powder, if you need baby powder, you know, during the day. I've been using a lot of baby powder. It's so hard to put on, isn't it? I mean, I wish my mom would come over and give me that one-handed ankle hold, you know. That'd be stupid, because I'm married now, you know what I'm saying? This is lovely. Look at this. Oh, it almost came off. I'm sorry. I was... Beautiful, beautiful. Fellas, they said no filming during the show. Unbelievable. I don't even know what kind of an iPhone that is. No, I had a mishap. I was in Vegas. I was doing shows, and I broke my pinky toe. Okay, do you know when you get up in the middle of the night to go pee, but you keep your eyes closed to stay tired? I don't even know if women do this. You should, because you get to sit. You know, we have to find the water. You know, I'm not hearing anything right now. Oh, there we go, right there. Stay tired, big guy, stay tired. Oh my gosh, and well, I was fine until then, but you know, I was running back into bed, and I kicked the bedpost, the one night I don't wear my Timberlands to bed, right? My pinky toe went right to the right, like this. And I'm hopping up and down. I'm by myself. I'm sweating. I'm cursing. I'm in my underwear. I'm dry heaving. And I'm giggling a little bit because it must have looked funny from the outside, you know. I remember looking down going, oh, my God. I could hitchhike with my foot right now. Ugh. So painful, man. And I had a buddy coming to Vegas to visit, you know, to hang out. And he kind of ruined the whole weekend because... Let me tell you something. You don't get any sympathy from your buddies when you break your pinky toe. My buddy comes over, he's like, dude, what's with the gauze between your toes? He goes, did you get a freaking pedicure? Yeah, my wife's Asian, remember? But that's not what this is about. Those are cotton balls, Einstein, okay? I actually fractured my fifth metatarsal. He goes, your fifth metatarsal? What do you mean, your pinky toe? Layman's terms, yeah. Read a medical journal, Einstein. And I gotta tape it to the fourth metatarsal for stability. Then I make a cast that's small enough. I go, I actually fracture it in two spots. He goes, two spots? I don't have enough room for one spot. He ruined the whole weekend, man. He was all pissy. And, you know, I had a buddy. He broke his collarbone, right? I didn't give him any crap. I said, hey, man, you know, I'm around. You need to ride around town, you know, when I... Same injury too, collarbone and pinky toe. Same amount of pain, same amount of syllables, collarbone, pinky toe. And you know, we're going to the show, right? Show must go on, and he's like in this horrible mood, you know? I'm like, dude, what's your problem, man? He goes, you really think you need the wheelchair? Unreal. Oh, you know what the ambulance driver told me? You're not gonna be able to go on tippy toes for like 3 days. Sucks for me, I like to sneak around a little bit, you know? Try and reach things. Anyway, a lot of gun violence now, man. I'm just so sick. I don't like guns. I don't like real guns. I don't like fake guns. I don't like guns when they're used to pick up women. Hey, you know what I'm talking. Hey, what's going on there, baby? Hey, how are ya? Hey, how's it going? Would you like to dance? Come on, move it to the fucking dance floor. But I get it, you know, I'm a homeowner, you gotta protect. That's why I'm taking this archery class, you know, you never know. But I'll tell you what, as an archer, you know, if I have a, if burglar breaks in, I got stuff to do. I can't just pull a trigger, you know? If a burglar ever broke into my house, I gotta, you know, you guys been awesome. God bless you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Stick around. George Wallace returns to the stage when we come back.
Come on. This is Comedy Live. Gotham Comedy Live. Nothing but fun. Have you had a good time tonight? Have you had a good time? Professional comedian. And everybody's looking so good. People are back in the cheap seats. How y'all doing back in the cheap seats? We love you. Can you hear us up here? Way back there, way back in the back. How you doing? I'm sorry I said that. I need my ass kicked for saying that. But a lot of people need their ass kicked. Shoe salesmen need their ass kicked. You ever go to a shoe store, you tell the salesperson, I'd like to see that shoe in size 12. They go in the back, they come back, we got an 11. These people need their ass kicked. The weatherman need his ass kicked. The weatherman got a new thing, they tell you it's 22 degrees, but it feels like it's 18. Well, if it feels like it, must be. A lot of people need their ass kicked. People at the drive-thru, you ever go to the drive-thru, you ask to order a hamburger, the idiot on the other end, you want cheese on that? Did I order a cheeseburger? I ordered a hamburger, and I want ham on it. A lot of people need their ass kicked. Any doctors in here? Doctors need their ass kicked. How come when we have a 10 o'clock appointment to see you doctors, we don't get to see 11:15, 11:30, 11:45? Then they walk and ask you, what's the problem? The problem, I've been waiting on your ass for an hour and a half. Then they walk by you, be patient. That's how they came up with the name, be patient. Doctors make me sick. Got me waiting in the waiting room, then they take me back in that little examination room. I'm sitting in that little room by myself. Open up those drawers, start stealing shit. You come to my house, I got cotton balls and tongue depressors. A lot of people need their ass kicked. Get a policeman in here tonight. Policemen need their ass kicked. Policeman just pulled me over for speeding. I told him I thought I was driving cautiously. I was trying to keep a safe distance in front of the cars behind me. Firemen need their ass kicked. A fireman told me if my house catch fire and I can't get out, go in the bathroom, fill the tub with water, get in there, that should help. Let me tell all you people from all over the country right now, if your house catch fire and you can't get out and you go in that bathroom and you fill that tub with water and you get in there, you might as well throw in a couple carrots and onion, bay leaves and bouillon, because that's what you're going to be, soup. Cream of asshole soup. And all you beautiful women in New York City, let me tell you beautiful women, you women are so beautiful in New York, this thing is just driving me crazy. And you're wearing these, look at the lady wearing the animal print dress. Oh, that turns me on. A lady in there, look at you looking good in that animal print dress. That looks so good. But now some of you ladies now, when you wear these animal print dresses, you can't be larger than the animal that you represent, okay? You can't be larger than the animal you represent. Some lady came to my show the other night in a zebra outfit. Everybody said, it's a xylophone. This is too much fun. I've got to come back and do this. Call your friends all over America. Tell them we're having fun right here at Gotham Comedy Live. the number one club in New York City. They're having too much fun. Come on, let's bring up the comedian you've seen tonight. We got some great, Ophira. Ophira. Eisenberg, come on, Mick. Come on, Mick Diflo. Cotton, Chris Cotton, and Gary Valentine. I'm George Wallace. Come on, Ophira right here, Ophira. Thank you so much, God bless you. Eisenberg, okay, Mick Diflo, Mick Diflo. Chris Cotton, Chris Cotton. Gary, there you go, Mr. Valentine. There you go, Gary Valentine, make some more noise. I'm George Wallace. I love you, and there's absolutely nothing you can do about it. New York City. Laugh Factory tomorrow night, Los Angeles. I'll be there.